Okay, this second presentation is focused on a new protocol we developed again, both with Sapienza team and Nazca team, that is called Primo. It's a protocol for emergency response, and I'm very glad to present this protocol and the results of this protocol here, because we used this protocol in recently in Bonorva, in the Bonorva landslide. Bonorva is a little village in Sardinia. Okay, before starting again, we tried the question behind the Primo protocol was how we can use the remote sensing monitoring technique after geohazard. To reply to this question, we developed this new protocol that is an emergency response protocol based on the use of remote sensing technique as a quick answer to support the asset management, of course, in emergency condition. It was designed for quick intervention, especially focused on roads, bridge, viaduct, dams, and so on. And because we work mainly with the structural health in the field of structural health safety, I I would like to show you this how the protocol works. Here you can see that an extreme event could be anticipated by a possible warning in the case of, for instance, of hurricane, floods, sometimes landslides, but sometimes this is not possible. So in the case of earthquake. So after the, anyway, after the occurrence of the event, in the first 2 days, we can set up, we can made up an operative response and a survey equipment set up. After the first 2 days, we can also deploy on the field multi-sensor data acquisition with the general aim to do a general risk assessment with in order to give to the politician, to the decision maker in general, useful information in order to take some action. For instance, if we have a negligible risk, no additional precaution could be performed. If we have a low risk, we can set up, for instance, an early warning system. If we have a high risk, we can realize some strong mitigation strategies and monitoring activities. So in the case of Bonorva, we decided to use a continuous monitoring, especially in the first phase of this process, a continuous monitoring with the terrestrial SAR interferometry, also called TINSAR. Just a few words about TINSAR. I don't know if, just a moment. Okay, TINSAR is a radar, a terrestrial radar, and the theory behind this radar is very similar to the synthetic aperture radar based on the satellite. So the radar is moving along a rail and transmitting and receiving radar waves to and from the scenario. So by using this radar, we can the software is able to create a bidimensional map, a kind of matrix with the value of the backscattered signal, in particular amplitude and phase. So by using some algorithm, by using the interferometric approach, we can extrapolate a map, we can create a map, a displacement map, and for each pixel of this map, also in this case, we can extrapolate some time series of displacement or velocity, like in the case here, you can see here. This is very important, especially in emergency condition, because we can also set a kind of early warning system based on warning and alarm thresholds. And yes, we deployed this instrument in Bonorva. Why in Bonorva? Because last January, so very recently, a landslide treating the small village of Bonorva in Sassari province. We are here in the middle of Sardinia, and this is the view of the unstable slope from the village, and below you can see the view of the village from the landslide body. From a geological point of view, we are in a sudden slope breaking between the basaltic plain, the basaltic plateau of Campeda, and the slope deposit with limestone here close to the village of Bonorva. So we started from Rome in few hours. Because we were called from the municipality of Bonorva, and in a few days we performed several activities on field. I wanted to insert here the timeline in order to give us some information also in terms of logistic and organization. In the first day, we carried out field survey directly on the landslide body. You can see here some trenches, some water collection systems. And the same day, the first day, we also installed the terrestrial SAR interferometer. This interferometer is on a rail, as I said before, and we installed it in a private balcony just in front to the unstable slope with a metallic frame that we called QIB, that means quick installation basement, in order to facilitate the installation of such an instrument. This is the coverage of the radar waves in yellow. So please consider that in that case, we reached the maximum range of about 500 meters. Here, there was the unstable slope. We went also on the slope to install corner reflector. Corner reflectors are metallic devices in order to improve the quality, the general quality of our measurements. This is the location of our corner reflector. And at the end of this field activities, we also performed a terrestrial laser scanner. Scanning from four different locations in order to create a digital elevation model and to spread our radar map, our displacement map on this digital elevation model. About the results. This is one of the critical results we made for a decision maker. As you see here in this map, the results is very the map is very simple. We created it with a traffic light logic. You can see here green, yellow, and red dots. Why we decided to use this simple way. It's simply because this map was for decision maker, not for technician. So we wanted to give them simple information about the evolution of this unstable process. And here you can see some red dot that means unstable area movement more than 50 millimeters in 2 days. Here another map of displacement. You can see the same area here. And this is a zoom of the area. On the left, you can see the amplitude map from the radar. You can see here a building covered by red pixel. That means...
Sorry, Saverio, 2 minutes.
Okay, thanks. So you can see on the right the unstable area in blue. Here another zoom. here the fortunately we had a very limited area where the landslide occurred. The landslide completely destroyed this building here. This building up to now seems to be stable without any cracks, any unstable feature. Here you can see the trenches and cracks on the soil that we mapped. For each pixel, for each point, we also extrapolated the time series of displacement. You can see here a stable point, and here other points that show the displacement, allowing us to interpret this movement as a shallow landslide with an impulsive response to huge rainfall occurred during our monitoring campaign. So that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.